Opus 18, number 5. He just whines when she's not around.
Oh, I know. She left him at me the other day.
It's terrible. He hears the other dog.
The first one has not been allowed during COVID, if I want to hold your hand.
Oh, go get him. He sees the other dog. Well, hears him.
The second one is Strawberry Fields, which actually John Lennon wanted two versions of this recorded, and they were in different keys and they were in different tempos. And then when the producer said, "Okay, which one do you want?" He's like, "Well, I want both of them." And he was serious. So the producer had to like cut and splice. This is back in the day before everything was digital. So there was like a tape for one and a tape for the other, and he had to cut and splice and put them together and figure out how to make it work that they weren't in the same key or in the same tempo, which may be why Strawberry Fields sounds as trippy as it does. But anyway, here's I Want to Hold Your Hand and Strawberry Fields. This is what happens when we don't have a library to prepare our music.
So that's Wolfie. What's the what's the girl's name?
Wolfie and Teresa.
Teresa. Okay. Okay. I remember now.
Yeah. All right.
put Ollie. Wait.
Thank you. Thank you.
teacher, great tune, beautiful night, beautiful yard. Thank you, Mana, for having us here.
Thank you.
So the next couple of things we're going to do, it's a Beethoven and a Beatles and a Beethoven, but there was a church, actually Francis's church, on the south side of town, that we stuck a piece of Bach in the middle because that's what the priest at the church wanted. He wanted something spiritual. I was like, well, okay, the Beethoven that we're about to play is really spiritual, but all right, we'll put some Bach in there too. So we played yesterday, O Sacred Head Now Wounded, and the Beethoven Cavatina. It's a late Beethoven from Opus 130. He had just recovered from a disease that he nearly killed him. He was profoundly deaf. And Beethoven had lost his nephew, his most beloved nephew, and he wrote this cavatina. So it's a piece of tremendous, born out of tremendous loss. I mean, just his whole heart and soul was poured into this piece of music. And so we thought Sacred Head and that. It was not too long after Easter that we played it, so we thought that would work. We're not going to play Sacred Head tonight. But we are going to play Yesterday, which is also, on a somewhat lighter note, also a song of loss, right? Many of us have loved and lost and understand that that sentiment. And Paul McCartney is the one who wrote Yesterday, and he said he dreamed it. I don't know how many people are Beatles fans and familiar with all the information, but he dreamed, he woke up, had this tune in his head, and thought it must be something that he'd heard before. And he kept asking his friends, what's this tune, what's this tune? And nobody knew it, and so it became the song Yesterday. Well, this song of loss, which is perhaps at a different depth than the loss that Beethoven had, the piece that Beethoven wrote, you might expect to be in a minor key, to sound really heavy, to sound like a song of mourning, right? But it's not. It's this piece of music that just kind of shimmers and allows space to process whatever has just happened. It's really beautiful. And in the manuscript, there are marks in the manuscript that Beethoven says that he wept as he was writing this piece of music. And you'll hear a large portion of the way through the Beethoven, there's a pulsing in the three of us playing the lower part, and a very sighing sort of, you can't really call it a melody, but what the first violin is playing sounds like someone sighing, almost sobbing. And so it's really a piece that I think is appropriate at the end of the year that we've all just been through to give a few minutes, and it's more than a few minutes, it's longer than perhaps we're accustomed to listening to in a venue like this. However, I think it's appropriate to take 6, 7, 8 minutes and just listen to something beautiful and allow a little bit more processing of what we've all been through. Okay? So these are two songs of loss, Yesterday and Beethoven's Cavatina.